Oh wow, everybody's here for the video today. One child, two child, three child.
Daisy, you're in my spot. Buddy, you're probably annoying her as usual.
You know, I get a lot of people asking me, Tracey, I want to know how to build a YouTube channel for my business, but I don't know what to talk about. I don't know how to make it profitable. And so I'm going to give you kind of a bit of a rundown on how I work out how to come up with ideas for a brand new business YouTube channel, because I actually do this for clients. So I'm going to show you some stuff. It might look a bit messy. I don't know if you can see in the background here. These are my messy notes. This is how I dive down deep into getting the stuff that will actually grow your channel. So I'm going to share with you 8 YouTube video ideas that will help you build your channel fast and actually get a return on investment on it. You know, get subscribers, actual customers, actual people that want to buy your stuff. Excuse me, no barking in the video, thank you. So I'm going to list the 8 categories, and when I'm coming up with these categories, it's so that you don't ever run out of video ideas and things to talk about in your videos, because that's another really big thing. And this could give you 3 months worth of content. In fact, this could give you a year's worth of content, okay? Just what I'm sharing with you in this video. So, number one is, and these are actually not in any particular order, but I'm going with trends. And a lot of people don't talk about doing trends. They talk about keywords and then what your customers are asking, and I'll get into that in a second. But I think a really easy way to get lots of views on your videos and people sharing your videos is to actually do videos on trends. So let's say I'm doing videos on home business and building a YouTube channel, or doing videos for your business. A good video that I could do during the whole, you know, COVID-19 lockdown sort of thing was to do things on how to build your business, you know, while in quarantine or something like that. So that's kind of jumping on a trend and giving either your views on it or giving some tips around that particular trend that is happening. And that is a really great way to get views on your videos and to get your channel some momentum, because that's really what you want. It's probably hardest to get your first 100 or 1,000 subscribers on your YouTube channel, but once you do, it is easier and easier. But in saying that, I would say for business videos, everyone sort of thinks like, oh, I have to have 1 million subscribers. I actually attracted a lot of customers after only having a couple of thousand subscribers, because what I was doing was becoming a go-to person in my niche, and then people were coming to me and I was getting paying clients. So that's the outcome that you want. You actually want clients and customers from your YouTube videos, because otherwise, why would you be doing YouTube videos? I mean, yeah, there's heaps of people that do YouTube videos for fun. My daughter does YouTube videos for slime and DIY crafts and stuff like that, and she is just playing, you know? But we're here for business and to make you some money. Now, to give you some idea of a trend that I was working on recently, was there was some YouTube monetization changes. And so I went and looked up what sort of keywords that I could put towards that and what I should call it. And here's the thing, you know, I could have called it new YouTube monetization rules, but only 60 people per month are looking that up, or YouTube monetization policy is 4,500. And so I might sort of, you know, put in the date or the year or something like that. When I give you the keyword idea as well, this will make more sense if you don't know how to do keywords.
Basically, keywords is really just, what are people typing into Google and YouTube when they're searching? I take those keyword ideas and I put them into a couple of different programs. I use TubeBuddy. I also use another thing called KW Finder, which I will list all in the description below. And I have another video on this, so if you need to go into more keyword research, click on that. Which brings me to the next topic, and that is frequently asked questions. What do you get asked all the time in your business? For me, it's, Tracey, how do I start a YouTube channel? Or how do I set up my channel properly, because I don't really know what I'm doing? How do I come up with good topics in my videos? How do I do keyword research? I get asked like, how long should my YouTube video be? How do I make my YouTube videos look better? I'm too scared to go on camera. How do I be more confident? If you didn't know, I used to be in radio. So I had a career in the newsroom of capital city stations in Australia.
Australia, all around Australia. And I really liked doing on-air stuff, but you know, I was in my little studio and I went into the little news booth when I had to read the news. But put a camera or a lens in front of me and different story. I just had to practice really. And I actually do have a video on this specific topic about how to get more confidence on camera. So make sure you book them up. So make sure you bookmark that video and go and watch it later. Okay, another really important one that you want to do for business is a video on your products or services. So when people come in and search maybe your company name or your product name or your services, you want to make sure that you are coming up in the search results with you talking about your product or service and reviewing it or showing how to use it and things like that. Because as you get more popular, other people might post a review video of your product or service, or they might talk about you in their video. And again, you want to be the one to be showing people what they're going to get and what your product and service is about. My friend Emma from Bespoke Backdrops and Branding has some really cool backdrops. They're absolutely gorgeous. But I do remember when I first bought my first backdrop from her, she came over because we live in the same city, and she kind of showed me how to set it up and all that kind of stuff. Now, she has videos on how to do this, and that's really important for her clients because I know she's got some new types of backdrops and stands and stuff. And so I was actually wondering, you know, how does she set these up differently to the old type? And so, yeah, I would really like a video on that, Emma, if you haven't done one. Now, if you have a type of service or maybe you do a course, maybe show us what is in the course. And then that comes to the next YouTube video ideas for your business, and that is Q&A videos or interviews with your clients. And this is a really way to kind of give people social proof, yes, that you are, you know, delivering what you're promising that you're going to deliver, and to see maybe some of the finished product if you have a product type business, or people using the product, how happy they are with it, maybe some questions about maybe you do coaching. I remember when I was building my network marketing team, and at the time I had a friend of mine who I had introduced to the business, so she was in my team, and she had done amazingly in the business, like incredible. She'd reached this new rank and she had signed up all these people over like one weekend. It was incredible, and she's so lovely and gorgeous, and I just had to interview her on how she came from kind of nervous mom who didn't want to get on video to being this incredible online businesswoman who attracted a ton of people to her business. So I thought that was a really, really cool interview, and that actually attracted some more people to my business at the time. Okay, I'm gonna show you one that I actually don't think I've seen anybody else do, but this is actually one that I kind of start with. I probably should have shown you this one at the beginning, but I'm gonna show you on my notepad here because it's really, really easy way to literally start generating ideas. And it's kind of like that thing where when you're not in a creative space or mood, or even if you think you're not creative, this can kind of inspire some creativity, inspire some ideas. And then once the brain starts to generate ideas, then you often just generate more and more and more. One idea will spark another idea. So let me show you my notepad. So basically I write down all the holidays for the year. So here I've got New Year, Australia Day. I'm in Australia, obviously. So I put down all the holidays for the year, and you can add in other cool things. I don't know, dog appreciation day, like whatever. Like a horse's birthday for the year, like everybody just pretends that like all the horses were born on one day. I don't know what it is. Okay, back to this, right? So when you write out all of the things, including like my birthday, I was thinking of doing a video on work at home mom gifts, and then like journey videos. So I could do a journey from creating videos from the beginning. Like I could go back and look at some of my first videos and then show how far I've come. So this kind of spurs ideas. I remember doing a Halloween video where it was spooky marketing tips, and you know, like you can do what you like. You can make it as funny or silly as you want. Actually, here's another idea. So Sherry and I are going to do a video on Aussie versus American YouTube stuff, but we're going to add some fun things in there. So watch out for that video. That is coming. If I've done it already by the time you watch this,
I'm gonna link it up here. You can do the same. Like, I don't mind if you take those ideas for your own niche and do similar. Like, you know, don't copy exactly your own ideas, but be you in your video anyway.
That actually brings me to YouTube video ideas number 6.
Yeah, I think we're up to 6. And it is collab videos. So collaborate with somebody else in your niche. Do a video together. I have done videos with that person next to me in the video, so at my house or their house. But my friend, Sherry, she lives in the US, a little bit far away. So we're gonna do a video together. I think we're either gonna do it on Zoom, but you can also do a collab video where, say you're giving 10 tips on something and one person does the 5 tips on their video and then the other person does the 5 tips on their video and then you tell people to go to the other person's video and you link it below in your description of your video to go get the other links. And like at the start of the video, you say, I'm doing a collaboration video with so-and-so. I love her because blah, 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 blah. Okay, that is a fun way. And the reason is that easily exposes you to a whole new audience that you wouldn't have before. Now, do not reach out to people that have maybe 1 million subscribers and you have 5. Go with someone, somebody who you think it would benefit them and it would benefit you. Now I'm gonna give you the second last one and then the last one is super fun, okay? The second last YouTube video ideas for business that will help you grow your channel is, let's wait for the bus to go past, looking at what other leaders do. Now, please don't copy them. You can copy the topics because if they're doing videos on a topic and those videos have 10,000 views, 100,000 views, random hair in my face, or like 1 million views, you can bet that there's a whole lot of people searching for that topic. What I kind of recommend, so I go to people's channels sometimes in my niche. I will look at their videos with the most views. So you can actually search this on YouTube. When you go to someone's channel, you can search for most popular, okay? Now I must reiterate, don't copy. But what you can do is take those topics and do your spin on it. And often I actually don't watch the other leader's video because I don't want to be influenced or feel like I am copying their content. So someone I follow, Sunny Lenarduzzi, who is amazing. You should subscribe to her channel. She's incredible. And she did a video a couple of years ago now on how to make a YouTube video with your phone. And I was like, well, that was a long time ago. Phones have changed. Technology has changed. I'm going to do my version of that. And I did that because I know that's a thing that people are searching for because not everybody has camera and equipment and all this kind of stuff. So I was trying to show people, hey, you can get started doing YouTube videos with just your phone. And if you need to go watch that, please go watch that. Can you turn that down, please? Okay, so number 8 for your YouTube video ideas for business is kind of what I'm doing right now. And it's showing you a behind the scenes. So let's have a look at behind the scenes of my video. You can see here, I've got my room set up where I'm filming. This is my office space. And yes, I have a child home at the moment. Well, actually she's doing homeschool. And this is just my ring light set up. There is my dog, buddy. Sometimes I have more lights set up, but for now I just did a simple background. There's my desk. And this could be a cool video on, you know, behind the scenes of filming YouTube videos. So if you want that kind of video, let me know, because that would be super fun. I'm sure Buddy will look super cute in the video. My friend actually did a video on a day in the life of a graphic designer, and I thought that was a really cool video. So anything behind the scenes people love. I remember this guy that I went and met once. I went to his chocolate shop. His name is Chocolate Johnny, and he used to show videos all the time of the chocolate factory, but then he would be giving tips on marketing and business and all that kind of stuff, and he was really cool to follow.
Buddy is so funny.
Now I'd love to know if you have done any other video ideas for your business channel that have really helped your channel grow or have got you a ton of views or clients from those videos. Let me know in the comments below if there's any other video ideas you think would be really effective
for business. Now I do heaps more videos on building your YouTube channel and running a business from home around your family. So there's gonna be another video just here and you can click that to watch more of this topic.